everyone. What is going on? So we have my Toxic Cup tournament, and I did go 4-0. This was a remote tournament. Sylph is no longer allowing tournaments to happen in person. They have to all be remote, which obviously makes sense because of what's been going around. So let's just go ahead and look at my team for a moment. I am running Escavalier, Barbaro, Golbat, Gliscor, Wormadam, and Drapion. So pretty solid team. As you can see, I opted not to use Toxicroak. I went with Escavalier instead. You know, when I made that video about Escavalier, I really believed that it was better than Toxicroak for this cup. Now, I'm not trying to downplay Toxicroak. It's a Pokemon that I love. I've been using it a lot in the Go Battle League, and even in this cup, I think that it's good. I think that it's really good. But I've just been a huge supporter of Escavalier, and it really did well. Now, as for these Pokemon, I actually used all of them in this tournament. It wasn't like, oh, I have these six, but I didn't use Drapion, for example. No, I put all of them throughout this tournament, and it was definitely really really tough competition as well. A lot of really strong players that I had to battle. All of my players were really difficult, so yeah, it was definitely a lot of fun. So as you see, we won the lead. We had Wormadam versus the Quillfish, so we're coming towards the end of game one. He does have a shift tree against my Golbat, so it's pretty much a wrap. Well, that's what I thought until I saw Hurricane. So he is going to go for Hurricane. I'm like, well, you know what? If he can get off another Hurricane, that's not going to be that great. That might knock us out. So it looked like he lagged a little bit. I let him get a couple hits in. I don't know. We just continued on. I was going to get to a Poison Fang anyway and win, so we just continued on. So I am going to go ahead and win round one. Well, not round one, but game one of round one. So we're going to jump into the next game. I am leading with Barbaro versus Hippowdon. So I was thinking, okay, maybe he'll go with Hippowdon. I was hoping to catch that lead. I had to make sure my Escavalier or my Wormadam did not catch that lead, right? So I know he has Hurricane, but I risk it. I didn't think he had enough for it. Maybe he did. Maybe I was wrong, and maybe he just went for a Shield Bait. I knew this one was definitely going to be a Leaf Blade. So we're going to be able to take that and feint the Shift Tree. But yeah, I mean, Fire Fang Hippowdon, I've mentioned it before, it's going to cause trouble for Escavalier and Wormadam and other Steel and Bug types. So I had to make sure that my Steel and Bug Pokemon did not come face to face with the Hippowdon. And funny enough, there were two people in this tournament that ran Fire Fang Hippowdon. Both of them were my first round and second round opponents. So I didn't like seeing that. I'm not going to lie to you guys. But I think we played around it pretty well. But that is something you have to watch out for. I even said it. I was like, well, I don't really think that many people will choose to run Firefang Hippowdon. But I think it'll probably be like an uncommon Pokemon. I think you'll see it. It's just not going to be on like everybody's team. And lo and behold, two people in the tournament run it, and of course they're going to be my first two round opponents. But that's okay. So anyway, we switch into Golbat, and this is over. So we're going to go ahead and win round one. So very good games, although we are jumping into game three because we do battle three times. All rounds, we did do three games. So next round, I do lead with my Drapion. Now, Confusion, not going to do much to us. So pretty good for us. I'm going to go ahead and just go for Aqua Tail right now. I didn't go for Crunch. I was thinking maybe he would shield it. He decides not to shield it. I decide not to switch. You know, I opened my menu to see what I had in the back, but I ultimately decided not to switch. And out comes Bug Buzz, going to do a lot of damage to me. And we're just going for Crunch at this point to try and get as much damage off as possible. I knew it wouldn't be enough to knock out the Wormadam, but that's okay. He's going to be able to finish me off with Confusion. So I'm just going to bring in Barbaro. I was hoping I could feint him with Water Gun before he got off another charge move, but I couldn't. So I just took the attack. Going to be that Bug Buzz. And yeah, I was just hoping like Toxicroak didn't come in right now. It actually is going to be Toxicroak. So we switch, but now he's able to switch. He does stay in, so I'm like, oh, he's staying in for a little bit. Maybe he doesn't have something in the back that wants to go up against a Golbat, but he actually has a Golbat of his own. So this game is definitely not looking too good for us, right? We're going to go for the Poison Fang, trying to bluff. He actually doesn't take the bait. I thought he was going to, but he decides not to, so that was a nice call on his end. Now he's going to go for the Poison Fang himself. I will shield that one up, and I'm just going to go for a Poison Fang. I was pretty confident he would shield at this point, and he's going to shield. And now I just decide, well, he's going to get off a charge attack. I shield it, and I decide, okay, I'm just going to go for the Shadow Ball now because I'm not going to be able to get to an additional Shadow Ball if I go for the Poison Fang anyway, so there's no point in bluffing. But of course, he shields it and he faints down my Golbat. My Bebel comes in, it's not going to be able to do anything. Even if we got to the Surf, he has like the Toxicroak that could knock me out. So he's going to go ahead and take this. A little bit of lag, but he's going to end up knocking us out after this lag goes through. So there we go. Goodbye, Bebel. But we still won 2-1, so really well played on my opponent's end. And we're going to jump into round 2 against my friend Ed. He actually runs these tournaments, so shout out to him. So I am leading with my Gliscor. I was expecting Galvantula because, I'll be honest with you guys, a lot of practice matches, whenever I saw a Galvantula, and I didn't face Galvantula a lot, but whenever I saw a Galvantula, it generally was the lead Pokemon. That's not all the time, but it was a relatively common lead, so that's why I went with Gliscor. However, he decides to lead with Flygon, which is still pretty good for me, because he's not going to be able to go for Earth Power, because we resist it, because we're a flying type. So he's actually going to pull the switch into Poliswine, and I switch into my Escavalier, doing a lot of damage. I risk it. I'm like, okay, hopefully this is an Avalanche so we can take the damage. It is an Avalanche. It still does a lot of damage. So when I said we could take it, we technically could, but not well. But we still take it. Going for the Aerial Ace to take a shield. So we do go ahead and take his shield. He will go for a charge attack. This Avalanche would be enough to knock me out. So I'm going to go ahead and shield that and then farm him down. So we do lead that. We win that lead, excuse me. And he'll bring in Flygon. I immediately go for my Aerial Ace. Wasn't sure if he would shield this. He does decide to shield it. So I'm actually okay with that. And he decides to dump his energy, which is really good. I thought he was going to farm me down. So Dragon Claw will be enough to knock me out. I do have that Ice Fang, which is immediately going to delete Flygon before he even knows what hits him, right? And then Bebel comes in, and he's out of shield. So this is a really great situation for me. I'm going to go for my Crunch. Just get as much damage as possible, right? I'm waiting for him to use a charge attack, and then I'm going to switch. So I'm going to go ahead and use my shield right now. And it's going to be Surf. Then I'm switching into Gliscor because we have the Night Slash. I didn't want to switch and then be caught with this, have the Surf come in and hit me. So I wanted to make sure he used Surf first so I could switch and try to get that Night Slash, because we were very low health. I didn't know we were going to be able to do it, but we were able to do it, and we took game one, of round 2. So the next matchup, again, I was trying to catch the Galvantula. Wasn't the case. I decided to stay in this match. I do not switch. I did not want to switch into Escavalier because he would just pull the switch into something that counters it. So I'm just going for my Night Slash, expecting the shield, 100% expecting it, hoping he shields. And he does go ahead and shield, so that's good for us. I wanted to get to the Earthquake, but I didn't think I would make it, so I just click on my Night Slash. So I decided to shield this one because I'm like, okay, he'll probably think that this is an Earthquake since I shielded. So I'm going to go for the Night Slash, even though I couldn't get the Earthquake, and he will shield it. So we do take both his shields, although he takes both of ours. Going to go in with Escavalier. He switches immediately, so I switch into my Drapion immediately. And now he's just going to go for a charge attack, which is going to be Discharge. That does a lot of damage, and he gets to it really fast. In fact, he gets to it so fast, we actually couldn't get to a Crunch. It's unfortunate I didn't try out Galvantula. I don't have one. So it's unfortunate I didn't try it out, because it looks like a lot of fun to use, right, with that Volt Switch. Super fast. I know it's super squishy, but anyway, Bebel comes in to knock me out. I bring in my Escavalier, hoping to faint him, not able to do so. He does get off his Surf, which is not going to knock me out. We're going to be able to take it, but it does a lot of damage. And then he brings in Poliswine. I'm like, does this Drill Run knock out? Are we actually going to win this one? Does it? It does not. It does not, unfortunately. But if it did, a little bit more damage, but no. So we're going to lose game 2. So we're jumping into game 3. He does lead Hippowdon. I go with the same team again. I go with my Gliscor, hoping to catch that Galvantula, but he decides not to lead it at all. So we're just going for the Night Slash. I wanted to see if I could boost my attack, hoping to boost it. Unfortunately, not the case. I liked it a little bit, but that's okay. So he's going to go ahead and go for a charge attack. It's going to be a Body Slam. We're going to be able to take this just fine. And we do have that Night Slash coming his way. I want to say he shields this. He does shield it. Okay. And then he pulls the switch into the barrel. I try to switch, but he faints me down before I'm able to switch. I thought I got off the switch, but I didn't. So I'm going to go ahead and surf, or shield the surf. It is going to be a surf. And I just commit to the farm down. A little bit risky. Honestly, I thought he was going to get to another surf. He might have been super close, but we are able to faint him. And we go immediately for Aerial Ace, expecting the Hit Pattern to come in, because why wouldn't you bring Fire Fang in? So I switch immediately. I have to get out of there into my Drapion. And I'm going to let this attack go through, because I knew it was going to be a Body Slam. He didn't have enough for an Earth Power. So I'm just going to be able to faint down that Hit Pattern with Ice Fang. And out comes that Galvantula, and we just go straight for that crunch. He's out of shields. Shields are down. We're just going to do it. It's a good Pokemon, but it's squishy. He tries to faint me down so he could have energy for my Pokemon in the back for enough for, like, two discharges. But we're able to faint him first. So really well played. Fantastic game. So we're actually in the third round now against my brother. So I get the lead. I lead with Escavalier. He leads with Barbarel. And this is fantastic for us. We're still taking a lot of damage from Water Gun, right? And he is going to be able to get to a Surf. We do get to an Aerial Ace first. Now, he's probably going to shield this. He does shield it because he wants to get to his Surf. It was a CMP tie. We're going to shield this up. And now all I have to do is just farm down that Barbarel. Unless if he decides to switch. Because he's not going to be able to get to another Surf at all. So, we do faint him. We do win the lead, even on shield. So, fantastic for us. And we have energy on Escavalier. So, it's looking good. So, I actually go for Drill Run. The correct play would have been Aerial Ace. But that's okay because he shields anyway and then he's able to faint me. So it wouldn't have mattered. I couldn't have gotten to another Aerial Ace. So I bring in my Confusion user. Going to be that Wormadam. And I'm going to take this attack. Going to be a Mud Bomb. We're able to take it. I knew he was going to switch immediately. So I switch into my Barbarel as soon as I saw that switch timer go up. And we're going to be able to get to the Surf. So this Surf, not going to be enough to take out Steelix. But it's still going to do a decent amount. He's out of shields. Keep that in mind. So I'm going to go ahead and let this go through, even if my Barbarel goes down, which it does. That's okay, because we could faint him with Confusion, and now we're just going to be able to Confusion that Toxicroak down, although I do go for the Bug Buzz to knock it out. But, Confusion would have got the job done. He was at a charge move, he told me it was a CMP tie, or he just got there, I think he said, but we still had a shield anyway. So we're going to go ahead and jump into another game. Excuse me, I forgot to edit this part out. I do apologize for that. I thought I did edit it out, but I guess I did not. So we're just going to go ahead, as you could see, his team, me deciding what to go with. Let's see what I decide to go with. I think I change up the lineup a little bit. I think I go with Wormadam, hoping to catch the Toxicroak, or even the Golbat, although, you know, Golbat's wing attacks are going to be neutral to us. So we go ahead and lock in our team. I think his team is locked in as well. Yeah, sorry about that, guys. I forgot to edit that part out. But we're going to go ahead and see what happens. Jumping into the next game, I do lead with my Wormadam. He leads with Gliscor, so it's not going to be a Toxicroak lead. That's okay. So I'll take this matchup. I mean, wing attack going to be neutral to us. And Night Slash, well, I mean, we're going to be able to take it. It's not a powerful move. It's a good move, it's just not a powerful one. So we're going to be able to get to that Iron Head. And I didn't think he would shield this. Let's see if he does. He does not. So we're going to be able to win this lead, I believe. He does go for the Night Slash. Totally fine. I'm able to take it. And that's just fine by me. And we're going to faint Gliscor. And now we have an Iron Head and almost a Bug Buzz ready to go. So Barbarel comes in and we go for the Bug Buzz right now. Just to get off damage against this Barbarel. And as you can see, it does a good amount of damage. He's able to farm me down with Water Gun, though. But that's okay, because we do have Switch Advantage. And we have an Escavalier ready to go. So I do bring in Escavalier. Now, I wanted to take his shields. But unfortunately, he gets to Surf right now. So I'm going to have to shield this. I really want to get his shields. So I'm going to go ahead and faint down the Barbarel. A little bit of lag, but didn't really affect anything. He does bring in Toxicroak. And I knew, okay, the shields had to come now because we're going to go for Aerial Ace. And he will go ahead, as you can see, shield that. Trying to get to another one. I switch into Barbarel to catch the Mud Bomb. Not sure if that was the greatest switch, but I knew Babel was not going to do well against this Toxic Croak. I probably should have just stayed in, because as you can see, we get to the surf, but we can't get it off. If we could get off that surf, we might have been able to win this one. I don't know. I probably should have just stayed in with Escavalier, but the thing is, he would have shielded an Aerial Ace when I got to it and then fainted me down with counter, right? And then he would have had energy as well as his counter damage against my Babel. So he probably, like, he would have won that anyway, I'm pretty sure. But good game. We're currently 1-1 in round 3, so we're going to jump into another game. I lead with Wormadam again. He leads with Wormadam, so it is a mirror match. I was hoping to catch the Toxicroak again, not able to do so. Totally fine, so I'm just going to charge up to a Bugbuzz. And he does get off his Bugbuzz, or his Iron Head. Let's see what he decides to go for. Going to be an Iron Head, so that's fine. Bugbuzz does more damage, so we're going to go straight for that Bugbuzz. So we should be able to win this mirror match because he went for an Iron Head. We do go for that Bugbuzz, and we're trying to get to another one. He's trying to get to, I think, a Bugbuzz as well. Looked like it was a CMP tie, so he's going to go for it. It's going to be a Bugbuzz. So we'll take that, and we're going to get ours off right now. So we're going to do a decent amount of damage. And I think I just try and just faint down with Confusion at this point. Yet that's exactly what we do. We faint him down with Confusion. Just clicking on Iron Head, seeing if I can get to it, but I can't. But we do have Escavalier, so we're going to bring it in and just farm up as we do. So he's going to get to a Surf. I will have to shield this. It's going to be a Surf, as you can see. And then we're going to go ahead, and I think I commit to the farm down, and we actually farm him down. He might have been super close to a Surf. He brings in Toxicroak, and I knew I could take both of his shields with Aerial Ace, and then we have a Golbat in the back. So we're looking really, really good. So we do go for double Aerial Ace right now against this Toxicroak. Of course, he's going to shield, and then we switch immediately, and after that, he knew it was over. I could take this attack. It's going to be a Sludge Bomb, but I might as well shield it. So he was hoping I had Babel in the back, but I brought something because I was thinking he would probably bring that Toxicroak. So I wanted to bring something and have it in the back ready for Toxicroak. So it's going to be that Golbat. We're going to be able to win. So we're currently 3-0 right now, moving into the final round against my friend iSavinger. You know, so it's interesting. I won 2 Mirror Cups, and both Mirror Cups, it was him and I in the final round. So that was really cool. Just something to note, a little Easter egg for you guys. And also another funny thing is, he was the only one besides me that was running Escavalier as well. So I guess he's a big supporter of that Pokemon. So we take that Rock Slide, and I was thinking it would probably be Rock Slide. I didn't think it would do that much damage, but it did a lot of damage. So yeah, we're trying to get to an Aerial Ace. He does get to a Charge Attack. I'm going to take it thinking it's an X-Scissor. I was correct. I did call that correct. However, it still knocks me out. I didn't think it would. What can I say, guys? I thought I would live that, but I didn't. So I'm going to bring in Babel. He's going to get to another Charge Attack. And I'm going to take it, and it's an X-Scissor, which is what I thought it would be. So we are successfully able to take that. And then he's going to bring in another Pokemon after we do faint down with Water Gun. Totally fine. It is going to be a Bibarel, and I go for Hyper Fang. I was like, well, maybe he won't want to use his last shield since he already used the shield, right? But he does decide to use it. He, you know, unfortunate for us, but totally fine. I was hoping he wouldn't. So I'm going to go ahead and shield this one up, because I still have 2 shields. Now I'm currently up 1 shield, and we do get to another Hyper Fang. I charged up a little bit extra just in case he was trying to pull some sneaky switch to catch the Hyper Fang, but he didn't do it. So now I'm trying to faint down. He does get to a Surf, and I'm going to go ahead and shield this one up. It is going to be a Surf, of course, as we know, and then he's going to switch into Wormadam, but I'm able to get to a Surf and do a decent amount of damage to that Wormadam. And then we bring in my Drapion. We do resist those confusions. Still doing a good amount of damage. This is going to be what I assume to be an Iron Head. Let's see. It is going to be an Iron Head, but we're able to take it. And we do get to a Crunch. And at this point, I'm like, wow, I'm actually going to win. At first, I thought I was going to lose this game. But we get to the Crunch, and we're able to just farm down the rest of the way with Ice Fang. And his Babel is super low, so we're just able to feint it with Ice Fang. And we take game one. So really well played. So we're going to jump into game two. Just one win away. One win away. Going to lead with Babel against that Wormadam. So just going to stick it out. See what happens. Trying to charge up for a Surf. We do go ahead and get to it. Just want to get as much damage or apply a lot of pressure against that Wormadam. So he will opt to shield that. At least we got one shield away. I want to take both of his shields. So I'm going to go ahead and shield this Bug Buzz because I know how much it does. So I'm going to go ahead and get to a Surf. And we do successfully get to it. Hoping to take his last shield. I want him to use a shield. He does. So I think when he gets to his next charge attack, I let it go. Now, I was trying to catch it with Escavalier. Not able to catch it. Not fast enough, but that's okay. I'm okay with letting it go down. Bibel is done. That's fine. So I do bring in Escavalier, and at this point, I do go for the charge move because I'm like, well, this will prevent him from getting off a charge move against me because this is going to be enough to knock out that Wormadam. So that's really good for us. So let's see what he decides to bring in. Gonna be that Crustle. Totally fine. I'm gonna go ahead and... Do I shield this one up? I think I take it. No, I shield it. Okay, I shield it. It is a Rock Slide, so we did call that one correctly. And we're gonna go for the Drill Run. You know, I guess I could have went for Aerialace. It's neutral. I don't know. Maybe Aerialace would have been better. Either way, it doesn't matter. He does bring in his final Pokemon. Gonna be that Bibarel. I go for the Aerialace right now. Just to get off damage. And then we're gonna try to do as much as possible. He will get off a Surf. This will be enough to knock out Escavalier. And that's totally fine. Because we have our final Pokemon going to be a Confusion user. We get Confusion down Bibarel. We go ahead, win the set. Win the tournament 4-0. Super excited. But we still have one more game. So we're going to go ahead and play it. I just jumped in with the same team. And I guess he did too. Because we were both ready really fast. Didn't really matter. I lead with Bibarel. He leads with Wormadam. He switches into Bibarel. I pull the switch into Escavalier. At this point I was so excited. I didn't really care how this game went, to be honest. But anyway, he's going to get off Surf. Totally fine. Do I commit to the farm down? No, I do not. I go for Aerialace because I thought he'd be able to get to another Surf. But maybe I could have farmed it down. But he decides to shield. So that was fantastic for me. And he does actually end up getting to another Surf. So that's why the Aerialace was the good play. So I'm going to go ahead and block that and faint down the Bibarel. So let's see what decides to come in. He's up a shield. He is up a shield. That's totally fine. He brings in Crustle. This time I am going to go for that Aerialace. Let's see if he decides to shield it. Does he shield it? He does. So we do go ahead and successfully take that shield. Trying to get to another one. Not able to do so. Now does he go for the Rock Slide? He does. So this is going to easily knock out Escavalier. But we have a Bibarel with Surf ready to go. I don't want to take a Rock Slide because I know how much it does. So I'm just going to go for Surf. And that's going to be enough to knock out Crustle. He comes in with Wormadam. And we're trying to get to another Surf. We do manage to get to it. So this is going to add up. We're trying to apply as much pressure as possible. And now it's a Wormadam mirror match. He's up a little bit of energy, right? But we are up in health. So this game is actually going to go to us. So we do win the final round 3-0. But it was definitely a hard-fought battle. And I want to thank all my opponents. Definitely want to give a huge shout-out to Jokes. Even though he didn't enter this tournament. It was definitely... you know, all the training battles we've had in the past has led me to this. And the reason I'm so excited is because guess what? I did hit Ace. I am officially an Ace trainer. You can see I won. I did reach Ace. And I'm really excited about that. I wasn't Ace in Season 1, but we are Ace now. So I'm really happy about it. So thank you so much to Jokes and everybody else, Trexler, for battling me. For watching the videos, I certainly do appreciate it. All of you mean so much to me. And yeah, I can't wait for the next tournament. Probably going to be a remote one as well. But that's going to be it for this one, guys. See you in the next video. Have a good day. Bye. Thank you so much for checking out my latest video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter. If you like this video, check out one of my other videos that you'll probably enjoy.